Learn Python after scratch. In this video, we're looking at finding the common values between two lists. There's a couple of ways that we can do this, but let's start off by setting an index which we use to find the places within a list. So we've created the list already, as you see to the right, and what we need to do, we're going to go through the first list first. So list one, we can just repeat through each element in that list, and then we can see the item in there. So we use the variable num, and that's going to equal the item that's in the place of the index. So we can see in our list one, we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, that's the index number, and inside are the values 1, 10, 22, 66 and 5. Now we need to find the item or that number in list 2. So if it's in there, that means it's in both lists. So now we can show that by adding that number, by saying that for 2 seconds. We need to move through the list so we can add 1 to the index number by changing it by 1. So there you see the code, and let's run that. So here we can see 10 and 5. Those are the common values between the two lists. How do we find the same values if we compare two lists in Python? There's the easy way and there's the more efficient way. We start off with a simple for loop. So for example, we can say for, let's say for number in, and here we have a list made up of integers. So we can just say for num in list one, and then we can print that number. So you see here, when we print that, we have numbers 1, 10, 22, 66 and 5. Now we have a second list here called list 2. So if we put list 2 in, we also, list 2 is also a list of integers. Now if we just change that, we can see the numbers in list 2, straightforward. But how do we look at the numbers that are in both? Well, we can use an inner loop. So the first for loop, we're going to look through the numbers in list 1. And then inside that for loop, we're going to use another for loop. And in that for loop, we look at the numbers that are in list 2. So we have num and num2. So if we print them, for example, you can see, let's indent that correctly, we're going to see all of the numbers. So the first number in list 1 is 1, so it prints that number 5 times with the 5 numbers that are in list 2. Then the second number, so on. Now how do we check to see if the numbers are the same? So we can use a conditional if statement. So if number is the same as number 2, then print them. So this checks to see if each number in the first list is the same as in the second list. So if we run that, you'll see that we've got two numbers, number 10 and number 5. So we can check that. You can see in list 1 it's 10 and 5, list 2 is 10 and 5. So that's the way we can find the same numbers. Now you may want to keep them. So if you want to save them, you can save them in another list. So if you was to say same values and make that a list, then when we have numbers that are the same from both lists, we would use append. Same values dot append, and then append one of the numbers. So let's not print that. So if we then print same values, then we should see a list with those 5 and 10 integers. So there you can see our list of 10 and 5. So that's worked. So what about if we wanted to see the numbers that are not in there? Well, there's a couple of ways of doing that. We could use an else statement. So therefore, we could, let's say we print the ones that are not in there. So you can see we have the numbers that are not in there. Or we could also do the same and append it to a list. If you don't want to use an else and you wanted to just save these, you could use if not. So if not, we can run that, and there we see a list of all the numbers that are not in there. Now you see there's quite a few duplicated. Let's say we add another 10 to both lists. So now when we run our code, we've got 10 in there 4 times. So we don't want 10 in there 4 times. So how do we make this a unique list? Well, we could say same values equals a set. So a set is like a list, but it doesn't have duplicates. So let's put that in the correct place before the print. So when we run that now, you can see not only we only got 5 and 10, but the brackets have changed. This is now a set, not a list. You may ask, well, what happens if I want that to be a list? You can then change it to a list by using the list function. So now when we run that, you can see we're back to a list. So that might seem a bit confusing. But if you want to look at a unique set of the same values between two lists, you can print them, but if you want to save them to a list, that's how you would do that. When we're comparing lists in Python, it's important to remember that we might see a number, but if it's a string, it's not really a number. So for example, a phone number 334455 is not the same as the number 334455. So if you try to add one or divide it by two, the program would crash. So if you have a number like a phone number that's actually a string, then the computer will not treat that the same as an integer number. Now, what about if we had, for example, let's just take that 10 out. What happens if we had some numbers that weren't integers but floating points? So we can compare them and we still have the same answer. What happens if we had 5 and 5.0? Would it be the same? Yes, it is. So the floating point doesn't make a difference. What happens if some of these numbers were as strings? So let's say the 8 was a string and 5 was a string. Now what happens when we compare them? Now the same number, a number that's in both lists, is only 10. So the same values in two lists means it has to be the same type, as in an integer and another integer. It can be a number, so an integer and a floating point, but a number, integer or floating point, and a string is not the same. So list 1 has number 5 and list 2 has the string 5, and they're not the same. They might look the same, but they're not the same. So when you're comparing two lists, the same value has to be the same type, although a floating point 5.0 equals 5 the integer. Finally, there's a more efficient way, and that's by using one for loop and then seeing if the number is in the second list. So we use the first for loop and then we check to see if the number is in list 2. So we can just change that if statement, so if number in list 2. Now when we run that, we'll see with the same answer we have 10 and 5 in our list. If you want to see more videos like this and learn Python, then subscribe and hit that notification bell. And when new videos come out that will help you, then you'll be notified.